guys, it's Alexis and welcome back to my channel. Finally, I'm back with another video for you guys. I know it's been quite a long time, but like I said in my last video, I kind of was going through a few personal things, but that will be further explained in an upcoming video. But I want to keep the intro short, so today I'm going to be showing you guys my fall makeup favorites. So I usually do fall favorites every single fall. I always do fall favorites with a variety of things, not just makeup specific, but this year I decided to do something a little different, switched up, and do fall makeup favorites because I've really been trying out so many different products lately. It's crazy, and I'm really excited that I got to been trying them out, so I'm going to show you guys all of my products I have been really obsessed with and loving. So yeah, let's just jump right into the video. So the first thing I've been loving is something I've been using for quite a while now. It's probably something you've seen if you've watched a lot of my videos, and it is the Mario Badescu Skincare Facial Spray with aloe herbs and rose water. And I probably said that wrong completely, but yeah, I'm sure you guys seen this all over social media, like on Instagram, YouTube, and everywhere. That's how I discovered it. So yeah, I've been using this and I absolutely love the facial spray. I feel like it sets my face and makes it look so set and dewy and so nice without making me look oily. So I'm really obsessed with this product, and I've been using it out through this whole fall, and it's helped my face not to get dry but not to get too oily. The next product I have been obsessed with is the Sleek Makeup Highlighting Palette. So, if you guys watched my last video, the makeup haul, you guys definitely seen this palette in there, and I've definitely been trying it out a lot since then. It's what I've been using every single day since I've got it. Oh my gosh, let me just tell you, the product makes your highlight glow to the gods. Like, I'm using it right now and it looks so pretty, and I definitely really like it. I love the packaging. The packaging is like the gold, like, mirror reflector, so I think it looks super cool. I really love it, and I'm obsessed with it. And it comes with four little highlights if you haven't seen it. It's at Sephora. I got it off of Sephora, I believe. I either got it off Sephora or Ulta. I got it off one of those. But it's, like, more of a drugstore item. It's really cheap. It's only, like, $12. That's how much I got it for. And it comes with the four colors, if you guys could see, and a brush. It comes with three mattes and one cream, and they're so pigmented and pretty. I absolutely love them. The highlights are definitely to die for. Like, look at this nose highlight. It's glowing to the gods. So I definitely love it, and I'm definitely obsessed with this product. And I literally need to stop using it and start using all my other highlights, because I've literally been using this palette every single day since I bought it. So yeah, that was my next favorite Sleek Makeup Highlighting Palette. The next thing I have been absolutely obsessed with is by Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I heard it got discontinued, and I'm really hoping it's not true, because that's really going to break my heart if it did, because this is my favorite concealer of all times. It literally, it's like a foundation. It takes forever to find a good concealer, and it takes forever to find a great foundation, you know? So when I found this concealer, I actually got it when Sephora was having like their sales, and it was only like 10 bucks, so I was like, $10, why not? Why wouldn't I try it, you know? I tried it and I fell in love with it. Let me tell you, I love this concealer. Like, it's my holy grail product. And I like it because I use it to carve out my eyebrows every single day. So, you know, I carve out both my eyebrows and then I blend it out. So, you know, with some concealers, they like dry up fast. So you have to blend it out right away, else it's gonna dry like that. And then it looks like poop and it's all ruined and messed up. This concealer doesn't dry it right away, and it blends so easy. I can literally like just blend it with once. I use like the toothbrush brushes. I don't know if you guys know what those are, the toothbrush makeup brushes. But I use those to blend out, and it blends it so fast, and oh my gosh, I love it. And look, it comes with so much product too. Like, it comes with a lot of product. When I first got it, I was like, holy cannoli, this is gonna last me ages, you know? So this is just what it looks like inside. It comes with so much product, and I still have so much, and I've been using it forever now, honestly. And I am in the shade 2.5. So yeah, this concealer was really good. Definitely a favorite of mine. Obviously, that's why I made the cut. The next product I have been obsessed with is something I'm really, really loving at the moment right now. So I'm a person, when I like a product, I usually stick with it, and I don't like to switch it up because, like, I don't know, I'm stubborn like that, and I really like the product. So I use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Pomade for the longest. That was the first eyebrow product I ever got, and I kind of stuck with it ever since, and I still love it to this day. Don't get me wrong, that's still my go-to eyebrow product for a nice, sharp Instagram look eyebrow. But recently I've been wanting more of a natural look. I mean, I could do a natural look with a dip brow pomade, but it's more harder to accommodate. And, you know, it's so messy. If you never used a dipper pomade, you would understand how messy it gets. It could get messy really quick. And I really was hating the fact that it would get so messy. That's the only thing I was hating about it. So I went ahead and tried the Brow Wiz from Anastasia Beverly Hills once again. And I know I'm really late on this trend. This one was, this one's been around for a while now. But I tried it out, and oh my gosh, I fell in love with it. Like, that's what I used on my eyebrows today. It's so much quicker and faster for me, personally, and I could get a quick, natural look with it, you know. It's definitely not as sharp and, like, bold finish as the dipper pomade, but it's something natural I could do for school in the morning, you know, when I'm half awake at 5 a.m. trying to do my eyebrows. So it's something I can brush on really quickly. And it comes with this spoolie on the end. If you've never seen it before, it comes with a little eyebrow brush, so you could just brush through your eyebrows real quickly, you know, when you're drawing them through. And then it's super thin, if you guys could see. I don't know if you guys could see, but the brush is really thin on it, so it's super easy to brush through your brows and just get that nice quick color in. It gives you more so of a color, but you could also shape it out, obviously. And then when you clean it up with the concealer, your eyebrows look on point. And I'm in the shade Chocolate. That's the shade I am in the Dip Brow Pomade too, if you guys are wondering. So yeah, I've been really obsessed with the Brow Wiz this fall. The next thing I've been obsessed with is also by Anastasia Beverly Hills. I have 4 things in a row for you guys of them. But it's the clear brow gel they have. And this is so surprising because I used to be the person that was like, what's the point of brow gel? Like, why do I need to get brow gel? I just kind of thought it used to be pointless, you know? I was like, I'm not going to waste $20 on eyebrow gel. Like, what's the point for it? So one day, I was like, okay, you know, I'm going to try it out, you know, and spend $20 on it. And if it doesn't work, I don't ever have to get it again. Let me just tell you, that was the best $20 I ever spent. I'm absolutely obsessed with the eyebrow gel. Like, you don't notice the difference until you actually get the eyebrow gel and you start doing it on your eyebrows every day. And you're just like, wow, like, oh, what was I doing without eyebrow gel my whole life? The lady was definitely right at Ulta. But I just got the Anastasia one, and it's the clear brow gel. They also have a tinted shade one, but I wanted the clear one because I didn't want to have, like, you know, a mixture of two different colors, if that makes sense. But this is just what it looks like. It looks like a mascara bottle, and it kind of has, like, the mirror vibe going, chrome or something. I think that's what it's called. But yeah, it's simple bottle packaging, but I am obsessed with it, and I absolutely love this product. And if you're one of the people that were like me that are debating on getting brow gel, definitely get it. Like, oh, it makes your eyebrows a million times better and should pop in and all the way. Like, I'm wearing it now too, so if you guys could see, I'm wearing mostly all the products that I'm talking about in here. But yeah, I'm really obsessed with the brow gel, so that's the one thing I've been really obsessed with. And then the next product I've been super obsessed with this month is something simple. It's an eyeshadow, but it's an eyeshadow single by Anastasia Beverly Hills again. And it's in shade China Rose, and oh my gosh, this eyeshadow is so beautiful. I love it. I'm obsessed with it. It's like the perfect, like, pink slash rose gold slash, like, burgundy. It's all the perfect, like, fall colors of pink. I was wearing it in my last video. If you guys seen the makeup haul, I was wearing it in there. If you guys want to see what it looks like, go ahead and check that video out. But yeah, it's just a single shadow, and it's in shade China Rose, like I said, and it's super cute and simple, and it's something I like to put on simple days, you know, when I want eyeshadow, but, you know, I don't want to go through the whole process of everything. I usually just wear it as a single color because, you know, it's easy, and it looks super pretty and nice, and I love how it looks. So I've been really obsessed with this eyeshadow, and I'm kind of sad it's just a little single one. I feel like it's going to be out so fast because I use it every day almost, except of course I didn't wear it in this video when I'm talking about it, but I wear it a lot, so yeah. The next favorite of mine is also, of course, guess by who, Anastasia Beverly Hills. So this product right here is probably my complete favorite out of, like, the whole fall makeup favorites. This one's my top favorite. I've been really obsessed with this. I was actually, when I first seen it, I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta get it. I got it, and now I'm like 10 times more in love with it than I was in the store. And it is the liquid lipstick set, and there's one color missing because I left the other one in my car, but it's the color I'm wearing on my lips now. So the shade that's missing is called Bittersweet, and it's on my lips right now, so it makes up for it not being there. But yeah, I left it in my car. So it comes with the 3 mini liquid lipsticks, and it comes in the shade Daze, and then Bittersweet, which is the color on my lips, and then Hudson right here. And it's kind of all like the pinks slash, like, not really nudes, but like more of the pinks and neutrals colors. So it looks super pretty. I love every single one of these colors. I can't choose which one I love more because they're all so cute. I love the packaging too, like how it just slides out like that easy and has all the liquid lipsticks, and the coloring is so pretty. All the colors in the packaging are pretty. I love every single liquid lipstick. And let me show you guys the sizing of one. So they're not huge, but it's like half the size. See, you guys can see it's about that big. It's not that big, but I feel like it comes with a lot of product in it because I use all of them lots of times. The one in the middle, Bittersweet, the one I'm wearing now, is the one I wear the most. And I wore it a lot of times, and there's still like almost a full bottle full of product. So yeah, I'm really obsessed with this. I think it was only $20 for 3 liquid lipsticks, which is not bad at all. You know, it's super good. You get to try all 3. And I'm probably going to be purchasing the bigger size of Bittersweet because that's probably the one I'm most obsessed with if I had to choose. But I love them all, really. And yeah, so that's something I've been really obsessed with. They're all perfect fall lip colors. And I know when it comes to fall time, I feel like in the summer, we don't really like focus on lipstick. But when it comes to fall, it's all about the fall lipsticks, like the browns, the burgundies, the maroons, just all that, the purples and everything. And I feel like that little lip trio kit saved me and helped me get the perfect liquid lipsticks for fall. So yeah. The next thing I have been so obsessed with, also that's one of my favorites, is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Subculture Palette. So I got this a while ago, and now that it is fall time, it has like the perfect, like it just has the perfect colors for fall. Like if you needed a fall palette, this is your palette. I love the mint green it has going on here, and then like the mustard yellow. That's my absolute favorite. I like how they chose to do the wording in that color. I feel like it makes it look so pretty. And then the colors inside are so beautiful. Like they're the perfect fall colors. Like there's a brown right there, like all the oranges, the yellows. I feel like this is just the perfect fall eyeshadow palette. If you were to ask me, this is the palette I would recommend for you guys. I absolutely love it. I came up with the look the other day, actually, so you guys may or may not, no, you guys will be seeing an eyeshadow look on it. I did one for the Modern Renaissance palette, so why wouldn't I do one for this one, you know? So yeah, I really love all the colors. They're all so pigmented, and I absolutely love them. So yeah, you guys are going to definitely see a look on this one soon. I'm hoping to get it up soon. I'm getting back on my videos. But yeah, this is just the palette that I'm obsessed with. Okay, so now there's 2 products left. I know, I feel like I went through my whole makeup drawer. Oh gosh, not even my whole makeup drawer. That would take ages if I went through all that. But the next ones are my top, like, the more, I don't know how I would say, but they're really, like, the sensitive to me because I've been going through this problem where I cannot find a good foundation anywhere. I, like, went through this problem for a whole month where I could not find a good foundation. I was literally in and out of Sephora every single other day, like, because every foundation wouldn't work for me. I have really oily skin, so foundations tend to oxidize so bad for me. Like, I could literally be a shade 0.1 in the morning and 0.8 at night. Like, that's how bad it is. So it was really hard to find a foundation. I was going through some, I couldn't find my undertones. It was just a huge problem. I mean, as of now, I feel like I kind of got it under control with these products. So I'm kind of really loving them, and I'm obsessed. So the foundation I found that works the best for me, it doesn't oxidize super dark for me, and it's a perfect match for me, is the Urban Decay All Nighter Liquid Foundation. And this foundation is full coverage, long wear, matte finish, waterproof, and oil free. So the full coverage, I absolutely love full coverage. I mean, I'm a person that likes full coverage because, I don't know, I'm just extra like that. And then, I mean, long wear, I mean, I want my foundation to last a long time, so that's just kind of a bonus point for me. The part that got me the most was the matte finish and the oil-free. So I absolutely needed oil-free, obviously, because I have extremely oily skin, so that was just a huge bonus for me. Like, okay, no, I don't need extra oil on my face. And the matte finish, I definitely wanted a matte finish. I didn't want a dewy finish because my skin's already oily as it is, you know? So I didn't need that. And this foundation has kind of been working super bomb for me. And I'm in shade 4.0, and the packaging is so cute. Like, can we talk about this? This is so cute. I love the packaging. I love how it looks on my face. I feel like it makes it look so soft and pretty, and I really love it. When I feel pretty, you know, I feel more confident. So this foundation really helps me do that. I really love it. So funny thing, the next product that I really love is the Urban Decay D-Slick Complexion Primer. And this one is the Shine Control Pore Minimizing and Mattifying, obviously all the things I need to help control my oily skin. So they came out with their 3 new primers, and I actually found this primer when I was getting my foundation, and I seen a sample of the primer. So before, you know, I was gonna spend like $30 on it. I was like, okay, whatever, I'm gonna try a sample of it. So I got 2 samples of it, and I absolutely fell in love. It worked amazingly with this foundation, and it still does. I'm wearing this foundation and primer today, and it makes my face look completely exactly how I like it to look, smooth, mattifying. And this is the best primer ever. Like, my skin literally doesn't get oily all day. I could come home and my skin's not oily, and this primer helps to mattify it out, and it doesn't dry my skin out either. So, like, it's like the perfect, like, in between. Like, it's mattifying it. Like, you can feel it tightening your pores and mattifying it as you put it on, but it's not drying your skin out. So I absolutely love this primer right here. And this foundation, these two are probably gonna be my top favorites, like as in how they work for me. So yeah, these are my last two in my favorites video. So that is everything in my fall makeup favorites. Sounds funny saying that, but yeah, my fall makeup favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give this video a big thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button below. And if you guys have any video recommendations, feel free to comment them down below and I will do them for you guys. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!